hits. Jocks and bikers, they all came digging in the sticks. Yeah, we're cranking up AC/DC, Hank Skinner, George Strait. Where's the girls? About to call them up. A little Southern drawl said, hey, trouble, what's up? It's going down tonight. And now they're pulling up and got jacked up trucks, slap covered in mud. Kenny Thompson, Daisy Duke Dillon, hopping out, singing outlaw women. And I'm on the side of them bomb wild. Girls and rules, if it don't, you gon' roll. So we hang out by the bonfire, just some good old boys having a dang good time. We crank it up, we get light, throwing down in the dirty, dirty south down here. Being all nighter with hippies and the hicks, jocks and bikers, they all come to digging in the sticks. Take it easy on the shine, stay away from other boys' women. That's one damn good way for a man to get it whooped down here. These boys tough down here, get your ass tore up down here. Being all night out with the hippies and the hicks, jocks and bikers, they all care. On the side of them bomb wild, girls and rules, if it don't, you gon' broke. So we hang out by the bonfire, just a good old boys having a dang good time. We crank it up, we get light, we're throwing down in the dirty, dirty south down here. Being all night out with the hippies and the hicks, jocks and bikers, they all came to take it in the sticks.
Mama's drapes, standing tall in the backyard shed, looking cool in my Superman cape. I told the neighborhood girl, said, hey y'all, watch this. My fate was a broken arm and my reward, one big kiss. When daddy asked me why I did it, I made him laugh out loud when I told him, cause the chicks and dig it. Scars heal, glory fades, and all we're left with are the memories made. Oh yeah, pain hurts, but only for a minute. Your life is short, so go on and live it, cause the chicks dig it. Oh yeah, the chicks dig it. Blacktop road, learner permit. Thought I was Earnhardt, driving fast, but I didn't see the ditch. Took out a mailbox, then a fence, then a barn. The police came and called my father, but I met the farmer's daughter. And when the judge asked me why I did it, he threw the book at me. When I told him, cause the chicks and dig it. Scars heal, glory fades, and all we're left with are the memories made. Oh yeah, your pain hurts, but only for a minute. Life is short, so go on and live it, cause the chicks dig it. Oh yeah. Oh.
What is going on, Anarchy Racing people? Kind of got some sad news, but then again, we've kind of got some good news to end everything off. So as you can tell by the title, this was the last race of the year for 2021 at Rebel Raceway. As the race went, I'll kind of spoil a little bit, but the cart just would not turn in the left-handers or in the right-hander. It was really, really difficult to drive. So later on this week, Michael and myself are going to set up the sniper system and kind of see if we can get the caster and camber and the toe right, because we think just something's off, something may be bent. Hopefully we'll find something. I do have extra spindles and everything else at the shop in the toolbox that I have. Kind of went blank for a second, but hoping to kind of fix everything, because racing is not over yet for us. The first weekend in October, which would be this coming weekend, they have a race in Jackson, but sadly we're gonna miss that due to work. But the week after that, they have a race at Shelbyville, Tennessee, which hopefully I can get my wife to wake up at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning to drive up there and go racing, so she can be my film crew for that day. But hopefully we can make that one. They have a specialty tire rule, so we have to run the MG Reds, which I have a set that I ran there 2 years ago. I only ran them that one time, and they've been wrapped up in plastic ever since, so they should still be pretty fresh. If not, we'll just cruise around and have some fun. The first time I was there, we didn't really figure out what the gearing was, but I think we've got some better views at it. See, I've got a 14 front tooth on mine right now, so I may need to go to a 15 or a 16. Just some changing that we'll have to do. As of right now, we have our eyes set on Shelbyville and possibly Barnesville at the end of October. I'd really like to go to Barnesville. It would be an extremely fun and exciting race to go. Probably go over there Friday and spend the night over there Friday night and go racing Saturday and maybe come home Saturday night or Sunday morning, either way. But hopefully if we can make that one, trying to figure out if my wife's gonna go to that one with me or not. It'd be a fun trip to go to. I know she would like it, just to be seeing different tracks and everything, because I've been to Barnesville before, I've been to Shelbyville before. So hopefully, you know, she can go there with us and have some fun. If not, then hopefully I can find somebody to film it, because that's gonna be the hard part. But so we do have some races left over. Some exciting news that we are going to try and do. Being, you know, that my dad passed, you know, in 2020 of November, he left us with all his stuff and everything else, to kind of just packed inside of our small house. I mean, we don't have really much, but it's slam packed with his stuff plus our stuff. So hopefully we're gonna get some storage buildings, and I'm trying to talk her into getting us a decent sized storage building so I can store the carts here and I can do more frequent videos for y'all. I know for all, we only have 15 subscribers as of right now, which reminds me, if you're watching this video just out there and you're not subscribed, please go and hit that subscribe button, give us a like, give us a comment, and tell us how we can improve or do anything else, or tell us what you might want to see. Hopefully, since asphalt racing is kind of dying down for the year, we can go see some dirt races. We should have some big ones coming up for Magnolia or North Alabama, or even why not, we can go there. I've got buddies that race that, you know, Evan Ellis, we've got Nathan Page that runs the street stocks and the flurries. You know, we could all get those, and even, you know, Philip Hall. You can kind of see in this video, his son Paxton's running in the backpack of us, just because he didn't have nobody in his class that go-round. But maybe we can go and see them and interview them and make this a real life YouTube channel starting to come together. So y'all sit back and enjoy. We've also had some more upgrades on the Tahoe that I bought way back in the year. We put some newer tires on it. They're not completely new, but they're new to me. So those should last us for a while. We put a brand new wheel hub on it that was going out, making some awful screeching noises. So hopefully we can lay the seats down in the back of it, throw the cart in there if we have to, if we can't find a trailer, and we will shoot off to everywhere we need to go, and it'll be covered and ain't got to worry about weather or anything else like that. But some stuff should be coming within this winter or early springtime next year. We are going to try and get, you know, some more vintage stuff, and I'm going to try and get an offset cart to run on dirt to maybe show y'all some dirt. You know, that's what I was raised on when I was younger. I keep on looking off into the view over here. I keep seeing something out of the corner of my eye. I think it's just a little cat or something, but hopefully we can get an offset cart, run a couple of dirt races and some big cash races. You know, we've got the motor for it, the open motor. We might send it off to an engine builder and have him beef it up a little bit. We can also try and go get the open motor from down there in Isola. So hopefully we got some big changes to do. If we can get a sponsor late in the year to take us over to next year, that would be great. I'm going to hopefully talk to a guy Wednesday about it. So fingers crossed and hope it happens. He is a relative of mine, but he owns his own business. He owns a speed shop here in Tupelo, Mississippi. So do us a favor and go and like his page on Facebook. It would be Southern Speed Race Cars, I guess. It would be SSR. Yeah, so Southern Speed Race Cars. I couldn't remember the last name of it, but I remembered it was Southern Speed. But we're going by there today to give him a talk and see if he could help us out in any way. I may be helping him out by helping him weld up a couple chassis here and there and weld up some rolled cages, because I am a decent welder. I'm not going to say I'm the greatest, but I'm going to say I'm pretty good at it. That's what I like doing, at least. And maybe we can at least do some trading. He buys some parts for us and I help him weld or do any other race car parts that he may want. But y'all sit back, enjoy these three races. It's the last one at Rebel Raceway, so hopefully we can figure out something, and hopefully next year we will be able to do more off distance racing like Jackson, Barnesville, Shelbyville. Hopefully go up to Newcastle next year. I know there's a big race coming up at the end of October. It's the Grand Nationals. So maybe we can go there next year. It would be a big... We'd have to save up a lot of money to go there, from what I've heard, because I know we'd have to stay there for 4 days, 5 days to go racing. Maybe we can borrow a friend's camper to go up there and stay in the camper so we don't have to rent hotels. But it's going to be fun. We're going to try to give y'all as much racing content as I possibly can. And we're going to try and get better at it as the years go on. If you can kind of hear me stuttering a little bit, it's because I'm exhausted, but I've got to stay up late for work because I work the 6-to-6 shift on night. So I've got to get me back going for this week. This is our long week, so we got to work it in. But y'all hang tight, watch the racing, and enjoy. See y'all later.
give me a play.